The pitch to Bell, Boney, in a high fly ball foul behind third base. May be caught. If it is, a run will score. There's the catch. Here's the throw home. He is out on a great throw and play by Pendleton, and the inning is over.
We have concluded an arrangement where Bruce Sutter will be a member of the Atlanta Braves for the next 6 years, and we're just tickled pink about the whole arrangement.
I can promise him 25 to 35 saves, and I'll promise him I'll give my best, and I'll be ready to pitch every day.
The 3-2 pitch is hit in the air to shallow right field, but it hangs for Van Slyke, and the Cardinals lead in the series. And the fates and the fortunes. Todd Worrell spends most of the year in the minor leagues in Louisville and winds up with a save in Game 1 of the World Series.
Coming through spring training, we were concerned about our bullpen. We didn't know for sure if they were going to do the job for us, pick up the slack that had been left there by the departure of Bruce Sutter to Atlanta.
Two balls and a strike to Pendleton. Here it comes. Swing and a hit into the left field corner is going to put the Cardinals on top. One run home, two runs home. Here comes Cedeno. The throw home, they could get him. He's safe. It's a sea of red here at the park. Here's the pitch to Muntley. Swing and a fly ball into left center field. Willie McGee is there, and that's a St. Louis Cardinal winner. And the Cardinals now lead 3-1.
Little squibber to the right side. Worrell races over to cover. The throw doesn't get him. Worrell got to the bag and an argument here. And here comes Herzog amongst the other quartet. First base umpire is Denkinger, American League.
Sure, we lost the World Series, but the fact that we won our division, we beat the best team in the National League West, we had a heck of a year.
Vince, when he came up, I said, you're only going to be here now 4 or 5 games. I don't want you to be disappointed if we send you back down. Do you understand that? And he said, yes, I understand that, but I'm going to be here the whole year. And I said, well, Vince, now, I want you to have a lot of confidence and everything else, but you're only going to be here for 4, 5, 6 days until Willie's better, and then you'll go back to AAA and get your work in. You understand? And he said, yes, sir, Mr. Maxville, I understand that, but I'm going to be here all year.
Swing and a line drive into the right field corner. Base hit. Cardinals take the lead. Coleman goes for second. Coleman flies for third. Coleman is safe with his fourth hit of the night.
Pendleton, it's a deep into left field. Way back.
Grand slam home run for Terry Pendleton. And the Cardinals lead 6-0.
Bonnie and I have been pretty tight, and he's been an awful good ball player for us. He was kind of a catalyst for us, and he always got things going. He's a hard-nosed ball player, but Lonnie's the kind of guy that doesn't want to sit on the bench, and we were in a situation where we just couldn't get him in there every day. It was just going to be like that, and we felt, well, the best thing to do right now is to go ahead and let him go to Kansas City. They're going to use him as left field. Eventually, I think they want him to be their DH, and I'll say one thing about it. If we had the DH in the National League, he'd have died a Cardinal.
Baseball has a continuity of night after night from the beginning of spring all the way to fall, and it's a real marker on your life and events that go on. I really mark my personal life a lot by the time of year of the baseball season. And you know, it's the year after year and the day after day part of it that makes it so much a part of your life. It's like reading the paper.
Here's the pitch. Swing and a line drive into left. The Cardinals lead. Hurst scores. McGee's 3-for-3. He's trying for second. The throw, too late.
Clark blasts one high into deep center field, way back at the track. This ball may go. It's over the fence for a three-run homer, and the Cardinals lead 14-4.
He messed up the 13-run pull, didn't he, Jack?
Swing and a high fly ball to deep left center field, way back at the wall. May go. Home run for Willie McGee into the center field section, and the Cardinals lead 5-0. Swing and a high fly ball into right, curving foul into the corner. That ball may go. It's up against the wall, and now there's Coleman streaking for second, going for third. They're bringing him home. The throw home, and he is safe. And inside the park, home run.
But the thing that intrigued me most of all is the fact that they were considered underdogs, and I've always been one who pulled for underdogs. And being around those guys quite a bit, every time I went around the first of the year when things weren't going real good, all you heard was, you know, we and us, we're going to come back. You know, they were all confident. It was never a situation where they, you know, doubted one of their teammates' abilities and that type of thing. And they just knew and had confidence in themselves they were going to get it turned around. And they did. And, you know, the rest is history.
Swing and a long one off the bat of Force. Way back, way back. It may go. It is a home run. And the Cards are on top 4-3 as Bob Force dinged one into the left field bleachers.
From a team concept of baseball, we were the ultimate. That's exactly the way we had to win baseball games.
Next pitch, Kerr running, swing and a miss. The throw, he stole it. The ball goes into center field. Coleman scores. Kerr goes to third. It's 1-0 Cardinals.
The Cardinal tradition is one of aggressive base running, aggressive play. So I think this is almost an epitome type team.
Coleman struck out, McGee rolled out, and a 3-1 count on her as Gorman brings it home. Swing and a high fly ball to deep left, way back, it may go, and it is gone for a home run for Tommy Herr. And that puts the Cardinals on top in the ninth, 1-0, a line drive that just cleared the fence and left on a 3-1 count. If Tudor can get him out in the bottom half, it'll be a happy day at Shea.
In order to change things, I went out every day and started working hard. You know, most guys show up at the ballpark about 4:30, 4:15, and I was there at 3 o'clock every day. I'd go out and I'd get extra hitting in, and before I got my extra hitting in, I'd go out and get ground balls, first of all, and work hard off going to my left and right and also jumping for balls and getting high choppers. And then I'd work offensively and go out and swing the bat from both sides and just try to concentrate on what I haven't been doing as far as relaxing and just putting the ball in play.
The pitch, swing, pop foul, chased by a few people. Looks like it's going to go out of play, and it lands. What a catch! What a catch by Andy Van Slyke in foul territory, sliding in the bullpen, and that's a winner.
When they went into Chicago and swept the Cubs in June, the Cubs hadn't started having all their injuries to their pitching staff yet. And in fact, I think we're right at first place or very close to it then. And the Cardinals went in and beat them three games when the Cubs had just mauled them the year before 13 or 14 times and had beaten them badly in most of those games. That, I think, told them they had a chance to win.
It is 1-1 pitch. Swing and a line drive will clear the bases down into the right field corner. Coleman scores. McGee scored. Here comes Tommy Herr.
Here's the throw. He is saved.
Ozzie stealing. The pitch swung on. Base hit. Here comes Ozzie. That's a winner. Was trying to steal third, and the little guy making his major league debut, Kurt Ford, ripped it into right field, winning the game for the Cardinals by the score of 2-1.
On any ball that I have to go to my two or 3 feet to my left or right, the first thing that comes to mind is dive.
There's a swing and a fly ball in the left. That ball may get down fair. It's fair, and there goes Ozzie on to third base. The ball gets away from the left fielder, and Ozzie's coming in to score on a double by Cooter, 1-0 Cardinals. Swing and a line drive in the right. The ball is... There goes Nieto for third with one out. He is safe in the Cardinals lead. Swings, and there she goes, folks. Way back, way back. 1-0 Cardinals. De Jesus corks it into deep left field. Way back to left fielder Foster. He can't get it. The ball bounces into the stands for a double, and there's the winning run at second base. De Jesus has a good lead, and here's the pitch to Vince Coleman. Swing and a base hit. Pass third. That's a winner. Here comes De Jesus. 2-1 Cardinals. A game and a half in front. Nice going. Vince Coleman.
Practically anything and everything that has something to do with the Cardinals is a thrill for me.
Hard-nosed, hustling performer who played the game with great intensity and determination, Enos Country Slaughter.
So this is it. Of course, it came a long time too late, I thought, but that's life, of course.
The Hall of Fame has been described by many as a museum for greatness. It's also been described as a place where those players who stepped into the pressure of the moment and emerged as heroes, and that their feet transcend their own career, and to this day, those feet still remains the standards by which the game is played.
It's hard to explain. I know that, you know, like I say, I could tell you how I'm thinking in that particular instance, you know, who's running, who's on first base or who's on second base, or where I'm going to go if the ball is hit in the hole, or where am I going to go if the ball is hit up the middle.
Swinging a ground ball. Diving play by the first baseman. He can't get it. It goes to right. Here's the throw. He is safe at home. Down to second is Nieto. The kid catcher has done it again.
Crowd hooting and hollering, and here's the pitch to Whitfield. Swing and a line drive into left, and Coleman races to it. Back at the wall, it's going to be over his head, off the wall. Coleman, a great play, throws to second. Could get him. He is out! Out at second base! What a magnificent play by Coleman in left field. The ball zoomed over his head. He caught it on the bounce off the wall. Whirled and threw a strike to Tommy Herr, who dived face first in to make the tag on Whitfield, and they love it here. Two out.
A lot of times you make plays and you don't even realize you've done things. You know, you have to look back at them. I've made a couple of plays this season, and the ball was hit, and I just reacted, and after it was all over, I'd realize what I'd done.
Here's a fly to right. Braun has hit a 1-0 pitch. Marshall to the wall. It's out of here. Steve Braun belts a two-run homer.
And the Cardinals take the lead 4-2.
Never say die. The team never wanted to quit. Every time you looked around when things looked bad, they could always look to each other and know that they could pull the game out, and that's something that a lot of teams didn't have. I guess the Cardinals' confidence in their own ability was probably their biggest strength.
3-2 pitch, runner is going, swing and up the middle, base hit. Here comes her, he scores, Cardinals lead 7-6. Ahead for the first time today. Here's Park trying to score on a misplay. He is safe. Ball gets away. There goes Pendleton to third. Pendleton's trying to score also. He steps on the plate, and do they count the run? Yes, they do. And the Cardinals now have a lead of 8-6.
Basically, when I looked at Tudor, I saw him pitch twice last year, and that was the first time I'd ever seen him pitch. I was very impressed with him because he could change speeds, and he did pitch inside, and he did jam people. I felt that he was 50-51, I think it was 51-51 lifetime coming into the thing, and he'd pitch in Fenway Park, which is a tough place for left-handers. And last year, his stats at Pittsburgh were 12-11. His hits per inning pitch was very good. His walk to strikeout ratio was very good. And he didn't really have the center fielder. He didn't have the left fielder. He didn't have the shortstop. He didn't have the third baseman defensively that we have. Plus, he didn't have all that big outfield play. And I really felt having those things, not walking people, not beating himself, would really make a great pitcher out of him. And right now, I consider him the best left-hander in baseball.
Kerr is batting left-handed. Could put the Cards on top early. A long look. Coleman stealing the pitch of the strike. The throw safe, and now he's going to be out. He breaks for the plate. He's caught in a rundown, trying to get back to third base. And now he's going to score. Nobody covers the plate. Cardinals lead 1-0, and McGee ends up at third base. You never saw anything like it.
We are advising players not to report to stadiums tonight. There may or may not be a later meeting this evening. There probably will be, but I could hold no hope out specifically of any progress sufficient to point us in the direction of an agreement.
There was integrity on both sides. We've been saying that for a long time, and that's why there's agreement today. Integrity. Some people have talked about my role. I want you to know very clearly that I had no role, that this was done by these two teams of people headed by Don Fehr and Lee McPhail, and they put baseball back on the field.
Ball, fly ball, very deep center field, may go way back, home run into the center field section for Van Slyke, and that makes it 3-0.
Swing and a shot into left, on the run, the left fielder, he can't get it, it goes by Reyes, Cedeno scores, here comes her, here's the throw, he is safe, and the Cards lead 6-4. Big pitch hit by Brian Hartley.
Here's the pitch. Swing and a line drive, and that's a winner, folks. A base hit in the left. 4-3 Cardinals.
All of my friends that I go to the baseball games with are women. We enjoy it a lot, and I can't imagine men enjoying the game any more than we do. As a matter of fact, we've been at the game where we've explained things and explained rules to the men that were sitting around us. So it's definitely a women's game right now, especially in St. Louis. I think there's an awful lot of women that are very knowledgeable that go to the baseball games.
Base is loaded. Cedeno waits. Here's the pitch. Swing and a grand slam home run for Cesar. Way out of here.
It doesn't always take a home run to win games in this ballpark, and this team is built and designed for the field, and that's something that the plan they have when they go to spring training, and that's just a winning attitude.
We'll be right back.
doubt about it. It's a magical place to be. When the team's playing on the summer nights and you get away from the work of the day and you walk in there, and it's just like our Disneyland, because we get away, you just tune it all out and you're into the game and those nine innings and nothing else matters.
Here's another. Swing and a long one into left field, into the corner. Foster watches it go for a home run. Cesar Cedeno on an 0-2 count puts the Cardinals on top 1-0 and may have put them back into first place.
Here comes a big, big pitch from John Tudor, the runner going, and he struck him out, and that's a winner. The Cardinals are back in a first-place tie. What a game by John Tudor. 1-0 Cardinals.
I think if there was one game that I would look back on, other than the postseason play, it was the game that Tudor and Gooden pitched in New York in early September when the Mets had won the first game of the series to go a game ahead. As it turned out, they would also win the last game of the series. And if Tudor had not won the game that he started against Gooden, the Cardinals would have left three out and might not have won. But Tudor pitched scoreless ball with Gooden for nine innings. Gooden came out, and Cedeno hit a home run off Jesse Orosco on the 10th, and that got the Cardinals back even. I think that was the biggest game of the year.
3-2 delivery, runner going, swing and a long one, way back. Clark has done it. It's over the boards, and the Redbirds lead 7-6.
All you could hear about was the Cards are back in town, let's go down to the ballpark. And once you were there, you could just feel the electricity in the air, and parts of ball games where it seems that there was no way that the Cardinals were going to win, you know, people stayed around because they felt or they knew that for some strange reason or some way that they're going to come up with the big play here, the big defensive play there, and at the end of the ball game, we're going to be a run or two ahead.
Here's his pitch. Fastball hit to left. It's deep to the track. Range could be. It's gone. Tommy Herr hits a two-run homer. The Cardinals pull off another miracle. Thing about Tommy Herr is he's always been a good ball player, and he's always been the most underrated ball player on our ball club. He's always been my best stretch drive ball player, and he's such a disciplined ball player, an intelligent ball player, that he does so many things for us in the third slot that gives the guys a chance to run. He pulls the ball when he has to pull it, and it seems like with Jack Clark hitting behind him that he knows exactly what they're going to throw him, but he's had a tremendous year offensively.
3-2 pitch, the runner going, swing and a shot to right center field, in the game.
We had so many highlights right towards the end of the season when we were getting down to the wire, and really the last 15 days of the season was just, it was just great because you really wanted to get to the ballpark early. There was a lot of kidding going on. We were a loose ball club, and we just knew that we were going to win.
The base is loaded, two out. Swing and a ground ball, base hit to right. One run home. Here comes her. Here's the throw. Safe, and the other runners to second and third. Tonight, Pendleton tonight. Swing and a high fly ball behind second, and Herr is under it. That's a winner, and it's 5-4 Cardinals, and they're still three games ahead.
That's one thing you notice in all the Whitey Herzog's teams, where the chemistry is always there. The players can get along with each other on the field and off the field.
Jack Clark still unavailable. Bouncing ball off the pitcher's glove, and it's going to be a hit. There goes Coleman, the pitch of the strike. The throw is there. He is safe.
I guess I took my glove off between pitches because my hands perspired, and I'd want to make sure they were dry when the pitch was being delivered to the plate, and I was trying to catch the ball. And I think probably that similarity existed watching the games, too, sitting upstairs in my box upstairs. My hands would get a little damp sometimes, and I'd have to dry them off, so... it's very difficult watching and not being able to do anything once a game starts.
The pitch to Jorgie. On the way, runner going, ball outside, throw down, double steal, throw home, he is safe!
it's 5-0. The running Redbirds. The Tudor is one out away from his 20th win, his 13th complete game, and his 10th shutout. Gooden picked up his 8th shutout today. Tudor's trying for number 10. The batter is Mike Schmidt. And these fans have stayed around to make some racket. You can hear them. This is a big game because if the Cardinals win, it means they will be in first place no matter what happens when they come home Tuesday night to play the Mets. Off the stretch and the pitch to Mike Schmidt is on the way. Swing and a bouncing ball to third. Pendleton throws. That's the winner. And the Cardinals stay 4 games out in front.
When you look at the stats of our complete bullpen, the fact that we haven't lost a game in the 9th inning, we have only lost 1 ball game, which we had a lead going into the 8th, and I think we've only lost 5 ball games where we had a lead after 6 innings. So that's quite a stat for any bullpen, and that's not only talking about one guy, it's talking really about 5 or 6 guys that have been out there.
Leadoff man is on, and a ground ball to Ozzie. Backhand stop and throw. Out over to first. Oh, double play. You should have seen it.
Here's the next delivery. Swing and a base hit to left. Porter scores. Here comes Ozzie. The throw, too late. It's 3-1 Redbirds.
If anybody had asked me this in spring training, I would have to say I couldn't imagine myself doing this well, but I also have an answer. I've worked hard enough, you know, in the offseason and during the season to be worthy of a year like this, and I feel many more.
Swing and a hit to left, and a runner's home. The Cardinals lead 4-2. The right-hander delivers to Carter, and a swing and a fly ball to short right field. And strike is there, and that's a winner! A winner! And the Cardinals beat the Mets. The Cardinals are 2 games out in front. With 3 to play, what a game, what a game. Enters Lee ahead on the count, the pitch. Swing and a fly ball to deep center, and that'll get the run home. Denier has it, Holman tag, here he comes. Cardinals lead, 1-0.
Eckersley fires, Van Slyke hits it deep down the right field side, way back, may go, it does. Number 13 for Van Slyke, and the Cards lead 2-0.
Change up and a base hit into left center field for Porter. The ball goes rather deep. The ball gets away from Denier, and there goes Porter all the way to third with nobody out. Swing and a hit to right into the corner. It's 3-0, and Ozzie's gonna go for 2, and he may make 3. He rounds second with nobody out. The throw to third is not made, and the Cardinals lead 3-0. Here's a high bouncer, base hit in the left by Forge, and a run comes home. It's 4-0. Now Forge is trying for second. He's safe.
Mm-hmm.
will get excited about ball four. It forces home a run. The pitch. Swing and a base hit in the left down the line. Fair ball into the corner. He'll get two. Left fielder Matthews digs it out. Willie's trying for three. The throw, he's saved. Ballard just shook up Cedeno. There's a shakeup, folks. Adios on a home run by Cedeno. Knock me down, will you? 5-1.
And before he threw the bat away, he just looked back out on the mound and said, huh. The pitch to Willie McGhee. Swing and a base hit into left. McGhee has done it again. Coleman scores. It's 7-1.
Here's the first pitch in the ninth inning from John Tudor. Swing and a ground ball. Ozzie to his left has it and throws one out. And Tudor has retired 14 in a row. Here's the pitch. Swing and a pop up. Ozzie wants it. Two out, and the Cardinals leading 7-1, trying to win their 101st game of the year and trying to win this 1985 Eastern Division race. Here's the pitch. Swing and a line drive into right. May fall. Van Slyke, that's a winner. He has it. Van Slyke caught it. And the Cardinals have won 101. And they've won the Eastern Division and headed to the playoff against the Los Angeles Dodgers. These fans love it. They just love it. Cardinals gather on the mound. Most of them who weren't in the game wearing those bright red Cardinal jackets. The color red, which means the red bird tradition. There's another for Mr. Bush. And the Cardinals will play the Dodgers.
Pitches. The runner goes, pitch out, and they've got Coleman hung up. The thrower goes to first. Wild into the corner. Coleman will go all the way to third. Around second, and he stands up going into third base. The 3-1 to Willie McGhee. Swinging a ground ball past the first baseman. Into right field. A base hit. Coleman scores, and it's 3-0 Cardinals. First swings, drills it deep into right. It may go back. Home run. 4-0 Cardinals. Thank you.
Yankees play, and the runner is safe as Royce boots the ball, and everybody's safe.
Arch started the inning with a hit. He's the 10th man to bat here in the second inning. The 2-2 pitch on the way. Swing and a ground ball up the middle goes through. It's a base hit and a run scores. Swing and a high bouncer toward short. This will be close. No play. A run is home. Base hit for Landrum. 7-0. Swings and pops it up. Ozzie wants it. And that's a winner for the Cardinals. 12-2. 2-2 in the playoffs. Cardinals have an opportunity for a first inning score. Here's the pitch to Tom. Swing and a ground ball. Fair pass third. Into left field. McGee will score. There goes Ozzie for third base. They hold him up. And now he's hung up. Here's the throw home. Safe. Daly gets set. Here's his pitch. Swinging up the middle. Good play. Daly has it. Took a hit away. Throws him out.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Smith corks one into right down the line. It may go. Go crazy, folks. Go crazy. It's a home run, and the Cardinals have won the game by the score of 3-2 on a home run by the Wizard. Go crazy.
Of a team. It was a heck of a year, and by gosh, our wonderful fans should have had a world championship, but by gum, we're going to give it to them or try our best to give it to them next year.